Theorem number 9, Taylor series, which is used to find the sine value using built-in function and without using built-in function. We can compute sine x using Taylor series given by sine x is equal to x to the power 1 divided by 1 factorial minus x cubed divided by 3 factorial plus x to the power 5 divided by 5 factorial minus x to the power 7 divided by 7 factorial and so on. In this program, we'll use the concept of do while. Do while is used when you want to execute the loop body at least once. It executes statements in the loop first, then evaluates the conditional expression. We'll start with the program. First, it starts with the header file stdio.h and math.h. So math.h is used to support mathematical functions such as f absolute value, that is absolute value of floating point number, and sine value. Using the concept of symbolic constant, we'll define the value of pi as 3.142. Next, we'll declare the variables which are used in the program. Then we'll allow the user to enter the value of degree. So let me consider the value of degree is equal to 45. For the further calculation, we'll convert this degree into radians using the formula x is equal to degree into pi divided by 180. For degree 45, we'll get the x value as 0.7855. Next, we'll consider the first term of sine value, that is x to the power 1 divided by 1 factorial. So numerator is equal to x, that is x to the power 1 is equal to x. Denominator is 1 factorial, that is nothing but 1. I is equal to 2 because the difference between these are 2. 1, 3, 5, 7. So I is equal to 2. So next we'll jump to the next term, which is defined within do while loop. Term is equal to numerator divided by denominator, that is the value of numerator is 0.7855 divided by 1 is equal to 0.7855. Numerator is equal to minus of numerator because the second term starts with the negative minus. So we'll put minus of numerator into x is x cube. So numerator is equal to x into x, x cube divided by 3 factorial, that is 0.7855 whole cube, which is equal to 0.48466. Next, denominator is equal to denominator, that is equal to 1, which is defined in the beginning, into I plus 1, that is 1 into 2 into 3, which is equal to 6, that is nothing but 3 factorial. Nothing but the second term, x cube divided by 3 factorial. Next is sum is equal to sum plus term. The initial value of sum is 0, so 0 plus the value of term, that is 0.7855, which is equal to 0.7855. Increment the value of I by 2 because the difference for the denominator is 2, so increment the value of I by 2. Now check the condition, that is f absolute value, floating point absolute value of term greater than or equal to 0.00001. In case if the number has negative sign, that will be truncated. That number, after truncating the negative sign, that is considered as a positive and it is compared with the other value. So we use f absolute value. So in this case, 0.7855 is greater than or equal to 0.00001. So this is true. Again, repeat the same logic. Let's find out the value of term, numerator, denominator, sum, and then increment the value of the I. Second time, you'll get the value of numerator is equal to 0.29904 and denominator is equal to 120. That is nothing but 5 factorial. So in this case, we are evaluating x to the power 5 divided by 5 factorial. Again, in this case, the condition is true. Again, repeat the same. So this is repeated until the while loop is false. When the while loop is false, come out of that portion and print the value of sum. That is, the value of sine is displayed twice. One is using the user-defined logic, another is using built-in function. Both the value should be same. Compiling this program, you have to use minus lm because we are using math.h header file. So the compilation command is gcc or cc space filename.c space minus lm.